do you buy this argument in favour of equality?
I think if we're looking at society, we value each other as individuals, and society does have a hierarchy, rightly or wrongly. That has always been the way. I think what this government have tried to do is to put the priority on having a job where people have a means to make decisions around the money that they have at their disposal. I think there's no doubt about it that the emphasis on creating employment, on having a job, to me, is the most essential way to be.
But the argument is that you can't move towards equality. You can't, for instance, have higher taxes on high incomes because that will damage job creation. So that is a commitment to further inequality.
And that's why this government have increased the minimum wage, have taken more people out of the income tax net, have taken more people away from paying USC. And undoubtedly, despite the arguments or the hypothesis put forward by others, those who pay or who earn more pay the most in tax. And this government is committed to creating jobs because employment... employment, having a job, is what gives people motivation. And if we want to look at it in terms of the whole issue of inequality, and the piece in the clip illustrates that, I don't look at people as being social pollutants or being whatever. I look at people as individuals, as citizens, and how best can we evaluate each other.
They didn't say anything about people being social pollutants. They said that inequality was a social pollutant.
But the point is, in the context of economic growth, and as we move out of recession as a country, we must keep creating jobs. That is the most important thing we can do as a government, along with...
Richard, isn't that a good point? We've got to keep creating jobs and to help with equality.
Of course, we all want jobs, but Gerry isn't really addressing the fundamental issue, and that is inequality. And the fact that somebody, a banker, gets €800,000 a year and a nurse gets €40,000 a year, that's unfair. Or that somebody who cleans the streets gets €25,000 a year. Now, to be honest, I think the people who clean the streets do a more important job than the bankers have done for this country over the last 20 or 30 years. But why does a banker get 25 or 30 times more than the person who keeps our streets clean and hygienic? And I think that inequality is gross, and our society is rife with it. And I was actually, before I came out, I was reading through the Credit Suisse 2014 wealth report, which is shocking. I mean, the level of inequality in this country is growing continuously. According to their report, we now have 82,000 millionaires in the country, and the top 1% of Irish society have 27% of all the wealth. The top 5% have 40%, and that, just to put it in context, is about the top 5% have about 250 billion in wealth. But the bottom 10% have less than 1% of the wealth. Less than 1%. Now, that is extraordinary levels of inequality. So I think we need to have a tax system.
You don't know how Credit Suisse came up with those figures.
Well, they have figures for the whole world. Very detailed figures for the whole world.
I don't know how that is.
They explain their methodology.
Well, I don't know. The CSO said they were going to do estimations of wealth. They were supposed to have done last year or the year before last, but they haven't done it. I don't know why.
Well, the Credit Suisse, just for, first of all, the total figure of wealth is provided by the central bank, which is 508 billion, which has gone up 13%. That's the central bank in the last 2 years, has gone up 13%. Credit Suisse estimates the distribution of that wealth based on extrapolating from incomes, the income distribution. And that broadly, with a few other sort of models, broadly is reflected then in the wealth distribution in the country.
Fidelma, you're so associating with people who are wedded to inequality. One person often associated with the Reform Alliance, Michael McDowell, thinks equality is a good, inequality is a good thing.
I don't feel wedded to Michael McDowell in any shape or form. I would just say this is a really important debate. It's a huge debate about inequality in society. I mean, the evidence is even, and I have read that book about 2 years ago, The Spirit Level, that more equal societies are happier societies as well. And even in the clip there, they spoke about how the perception is that people that are wealthier may be happier, but they're often barricaded away in their homes. Yet, so that's a myth as well. Now, this is not a simple an easy thing to change a society into, because our society is actually quite unequal. And so I think it's not a matter of just tweaking at the edges. It's a complete overhaul. And we have to look at societies that are considered more equal, such as we're talking about the Nordic countries. Denmark is one that's held up as quite a shining light in this area for happier people, better services, better quality of life generally. So I think it's certainly worth looking at. And in terms of our own ethos in Reform Alliance, we certainly value work, but we also value good services, and we'd value a very fair tax system that would give everyone a chance.
Would you increase the top level of tax on people, on our high earners?
I think the top level of tax is actually too high in this country, Vincent. It's at 52% at the moment. Let's call a spade a spade here. That's why I say we need a complete overhaul of how we look at this. Because at the moment, we pretend we're not on high taxes here. We're on extremely high taxes. For example, a Finnish person I know at the moment on 200,000 a year is on about 50% tax. A lot of people are here paying 52 to 53% tax.
Do you think there's anybody in society paying 52% of their income in tax? Anybody? It's even one person?
Yes.
Who?
No, there's not.
Can you think of anyone?
Add it up.
There isn't anybody.
Vincent, you've got your 40-odd% top level. Add on your USC. Add on the very, not taking into account the stealth taxes. Taxes are extremely high here. If we want a very fair society, we need a fairer tax system that's going to liberate our employers to create more jobs. And let's get at it.
I don't know how people keep on saying this, but it's just not true. The Revenue Commission has published data every now and again that shows that even if you add up income tax, the PSRI and the USC, nobody is paying 52%, not a single person. They might be paying something like 42 or 43%, but that's it. And even people paying earning over 200,000, they pay income tax of about 32, 33%. That's all.
Over 200,000?
Yes.
In fact, that might be where the injustice is. I'm talking about people on 50, 60,000 to 100,000, that range is incredibly taxed.
But there's not nobody is
shocked.
But nobody pays 52% of their total income in tax. Nobody. But you're talking about you're talking about the marginal rate. Yes, people pay that at the marginal
exactly.
rate. That's but exactly is not the effective rate. They pay it at the marginal rate. That's true.
Yes, but I'm talking about the marginal rate.
Yeah, well, then you're talking about something radically different. In any event, let's talk a bit about the issues that rose in the doll today, the question of the dossier thing.